Hi, this is Edwin from GetNotes. Let's continue reviewing what's new in Revit 2023. Now in this version, we have the connection automation tool next to the old still connection. This is actually not a new feature because in Revit 2022, Autodesk already provide this as a Dynamo player samples. This one is also actually a Dynamo scripts, but instead of you need opening the Dynamo player, you can just click this button and it will open the script for connection automation only. Now you can select what automation that you want to create. For example, this one is for base plate. I can select all my column that I want to create the base plate. You can select if all the column should be having the base plate, or you can be more specific and select only specific profile and specific size. Let's just create all, and now you can select the steel connection type. I will use the base plate and I click run. Now we have all the steel connection here. The connection automation allows you to be very specific about which connection type should apply to your structure. You can define all the connection in your connection library file. So here I create a simple connection library file in spirit file. Let's check this connection type properties. If I click edit type, I have a parameter modify ranges of applicability. So here I can define if my beam here, the IPE 120, so it must be IPE beams with this specific size, the IPE 120. If it connects to another beam with also IPE beams, but for any sizes, then it will use this connection type. You can also be more specific by defining the material. So if the material is 300W grade 275, but now I will just select any, and you can also define if the member has minimum and maximum value for these forces. Okay, let's check the other one. Okay, this steel connection is clip angle. I also create a specific type for IPE 200. Here we can also check the ranges of applicability. Again, this only applies if the beam is IPE beam and the size should be specific to IPE 200, and it can connect if the main beam size is IPE 200 to 40 and IPE 300. Okay, let's try this. Now let's try to create the automatic connection by searching by ranges. Okay, so this one is what we are looking for, beam to beam by ranges. Let's select all the elements. You can define more specific properties if you want, and here we can define the connection library file. And the connection family to place is clip angle, and the other one is clip angle queue. So you can define multiple connection family if you need to. The select analysis result, we can ignore this because we don't define that in the connection library. Now we can run this automation. Okay, we can see the report now. It's for clip angles queue. It created 8 instances, and for IPE 200, it created 18 instances. Let's check in our model. So this one is IPE 120. This one also IPE 120, and it uses the right connection, and this one is also using the correct connection. So this is very useful if you have the connection library and want to apply them quickly in your model. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel.